And I'm so glad to see so many of my former inmates here. And don't raise your hands. Keep it down. Everybody's putting their hands up. You know, it's a sin to lie. So glad to see you all here. What a turnout. You know, when I do celebrations of life, and I do a lot of them here in Pahrump, it's always such a pleasure to see how people have shown up in their lives. And it demonstrates itself of how they showed up by how they show up at a time like this. So welcome to all of you, and God bless you for being here. It's an honor and a privilege to be able to officiate this service today. And I know it's a sad moment, sad for me, as well as you guys. But it's also a joyous moment, isn't it? Because we're here to celebrate. And again, like I said, it's my honor to be here to celebrate Angel's life. I guess we're ready to start. Cameras ready back there? Cameras? Oh, everything's good. Okay. Well, let me start off by saying that St. Paul said in his second letter to the Corinthians that to be absent of the body is to be present with the Lord. And sure enough, I truly believe that Angel joined the Lord on that day that she passed, even though her body, her remains, may still be here on earth with us. So I want to just remind everybody, too, when you think about Angel, look up. Look up and know that Angel, no doubt, is looking down on us right now at this period of time, watching us celebrate the time that God gave us to spend with all of you guys while she was here on earth. And while the service is truly, it's about Angel, but you know what? It's for you. This service today is primarily for you. So feel free to mourn, to cry, even to laugh, if you will, because this is your time to celebrate Angel's life. Amen? Amen? Amen. So please bow your heads. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the time that you blessed this loving family and friends with Angel's presence. We thank you for this blessing and for all the blessings you bestow on us each and every day. We know that Angel is with you right now and look forward to the day when we too will join you in heaven. I pray this in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And everyone says, amen. Amen. God bless you. You know, Angel was one of my fans of old gospel music at Central Valley. And I dubbed the angels that sang with her as the Angel Choir. You may have seen that up there on the screen. And that consisted, of course, of her good friend, Marcia, and various other church members from time to time. So why don't we, in honor of Angel, why don't we form a new Angel Choir today? Okay, and honor her and sing some good old gospel songs. What do you say? Huh? All right, well, come on up front. Anybody that would like to be in the new Angel Choir, come on up here, get up front, and we're gonna sing some good old gospel music. Now, when they come up here, I just want to ask everybody else, even though we have the Angel Choir here, and we got mic number 5, I'll turn that on. That's number 5, and this is number 1.
Does anybody else
want to
come up?
I'm going to go encouraging.
I know we have more
singers. Is everybody else here shy?
I know, there's like more singers.
So if you like singing good old gospel music, come on up front. Ron, get up here. You got your harmonica? Well, you get up here and sing anyways. Okay, let me see here. You come up front, please. Come on, up front. You. Oh, you're coughing? Spit it out and come on up front. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Okay. Are you feeling better now?
No.
No, okay. Okay. All right. So this is our new Angel Choir, and let's see, what can we pass the, well, you guys gather around, put it in the middle between all of you there, and we can, all right, maestro.
Maestro.
Check.
Angel, I know you're listening. Here you go.
Sound good.
All right. The New Angel Choir. And you all sound pretty good out there too, so please sing it up. All right. We have another one here. Dum, 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 dum. Here we go. I Got a River of Life.
Flowing within me, makes the lame to walk and the blind to see. Opens doors and doors that the deaf is free.
I've got a river of life flowing within me, spring up a well within my spirit. Rise up and tell, oh Lord, all can hear it. Spring up a well.
Gushing up when God set me free.
That I keep the flow is my only plea.
A river of life drinking within me. Spring up a well within my spirit.
Rise up and tell, oh Lord, all can hear it.
Spring up a well, so I experience the life abundantly.
From my day makes him Lord again. As my spirit burns, Satan cannot win.
Calling over Jesus keeps the flow within.
Spring up a well
within my spirit.
Rise up and tell, oh Lord, all can hear it.
Spring up a well,
so I experience the life abundantly.
Abundantly, abundantly, abundantly.
Abundantly, abundantly, abundantly.
A river of life flowing out of me.
Spring up a well
within my spirit.
Rise up and tell, oh Lord, all can hear it.
Spring up a well,
so I experience the life abundantly.
Yes. All right. That was a little bit different version than I, but you did well. Abundantly. All right.
Still
Cherish the old rugged cross.
seated. Now that's the way to honor our good friend Angel, huh? Wow. This is a reading from the 23rd Psalm from the Word of God. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup runs over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. This is the word of God. You know, I know it's sad when we lose someone that we love and we know. But as Christians, we know there's a time to live and a time to die, don't we? And that this is not the time to say goodbye to Angel, but a time to say, till we meet again. You know, there's a great song. It was written by a very wise man by the name of King Solomon. It was written about around the year 935 BC. That song is as relevant today as it was back then. You know, it was actually recorded in the Old Testament in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3. And some of you kids here may remember a group called the Birds. Anybody remember the Birds? And they recorded that song. And what'd they title it? Anybody remember? Turn, turn, turn. There's a time for everything, huh? Please, allow me to read the lyrics to that song. There's a season for everything, and a time for every event under the heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot what was planted. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather stones. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up searching. A time to keep and a time to discard. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. Amen? Yes, there is a time for everything. And what do I know about this time in honoring my friend Angel, the loving wife, mother, grandmother, and friend? She was a good friend, a sweet lady, and like my church music and my sermons. She's a big fan. Yeah, I understand from Ken that she was once a Las Vegas showgirl, a job that Ken didn't like. Right, Ken? Yeah. But I won't pretend that I knew Angel as many of you did, you know? You who came here today, God bless you, to honor your family members, your friend, and Angel, the Angel that you knew best. You who loved Angel and made a point of being here today to honor her, certainly will treasure those memories of Angel that you shared with her, huh? Let me read a short piece here from Angel's obituary. On March 19th, 2022, our beloved Angel, Carter Meisner, birth name Evelyn Dorth, is that correct? Dorth, is that correct pronunciation? Okay, she was called home by her Heavenly Father. She will be remembered as a loving wife, mother, and grandmother, and friend to all those that knew her. She lived an amazing life filled with so many adventures and experiences that most of us can only dream of. She was active in her churches and was always there to help in any way. She could give you words of wisdom or the tough love you needed, huh? She was one of a kind, and she'll be deeply missed by all who knew her. She is survived by her loving husband, Ken, daughter, Janine, son, Daniel, and grandchildren, Tara Craver, Travis, Nick, and Brittany, oh boy, Chandervelt, and six great-grandchildren. May she rest in peace, our beautiful angel, until we meet again. Well, that's just a little bit about who she was, huh? Who was Angel? What memories do you have? You know, this is a time, by the way, that we share memories. That's what this is all about. That's what we call the celebration of life. And it gives us an opportunity to reflect on those memories, those times that you spent with Angel, that she made you laugh, made you cry, made you love God a little bit more because of the way she presented herself. So, who would like to be first to share those memories?
Use a microphone.
Oh, I have a microphone. Oh, for you? Am I not using it? Okay, you'd like to be first? Okay.
Yeah.
And you have to speak into the mic.
Ken, my two greatest memories of Angel is when I first met you guys and we sat down and had lunch, and then I started working for you guys, delivering cubes. And my second memory is when we were at Michael's delivering cubes and we were having problems with the truck staying charged. I ended up jumping off of the bed of the truck and pushing Angel out of the way so the truck didn't hit her.
Whoa. That's a good memory. All right. Who would like to be next? And don't all jump up at the same time. Okay. Marcia, come on.
When I first met Angel, it was my husband and Ken that met first. And they both had such similar minds. They both thought so much alike, like two little brothers from different mothers. So. But he brought Angel up to our place, and Angel and I had so much in common. We loved our kitty cats. We both loved our German Shepherd dogs. And we just hit off a friendship that will last forever, I know. And I enjoyed singing with her so much, even here at Heritage when we first joined here. We were both up on that stage singing. And so every time I sing, I do remember Angel too. So she'll stay in my heart forever. Okay, love you, Angel.
Me too. All right. Okay. Oh, you'd like to say a few words? Okay.
Angel was, when I started coming to church here, Angel was one of the first people I met. She could be really crabby when it came to her husband, Ken, let me tell you. We've had a couple of run-ins because of Ken, and she protected her man. But on the flip side, Angel, she would tell you like it was, you know. She didn't hold back punches, you know. She would tell me if I was messing up or whatever, I was doing good. But again, the song "I'll Fly Away," you know, I'll never be able to sing that song without hearing Angel. She will be missed.
All right, thank you. Okay. I'm coming back to you.
Angel was my friend, someone that you could depend on. She was always positive. She was always a beautiful soul, and I will miss her terribly. We sang together at the church, and I will just miss her terribly.
Thank you. Okay, coming over.
I also met Angel here many years ago, and
She was such a, just a beautiful soul. She never had anything negative to say about anything. And we did a lot of Bible study classes together, and I will always remember her as Angel.
Thank you. Okay. I'm looking for another victim. I mean, person. Christian would like to share. Jennifer, would you like to say a few words? It's too late to say no.
She was a lovely lady, and she was kind to me. And she had a big heart, and I enjoyed talking with her.
That's good. Thank you. And I'm coming around this way. Again, just raise your hand. Okay, I'm coming over there to you. But, oh, back here. Stand by. Hold that hand. Yes.
I was privileged to meet Angel many years ago in this very church. She was a dear, sweet lady, and we got along really well. And I was privileged to be invited to her and Ken's home for Thanksgiving a year ago. Marcia was there and another couple, I didn't remember the name, but it was a wonderful time of enjoyment with the Lord's presence there. She was precious.
She was. Thank you. Yes, come on, Meg.
I will never forget Angel. I mean, I tell you, she was the most happy person that I ever met. And I used to love to sit next to her, and she was so happy when, you know, and any time when she really believed in the sermon, she'd scream out, "Amen, hallelujah," you know. And when we sang, I mean, boy, did she sing and get into it just like I do. So I really miss her because I think I'm the only one that's left that gets really excited when we're singing. She was just a sweetheart, and we're going to miss her.
Hallelujah. All right, I'm coming up to the front, but just so I don't miss anybody, and I know my wife is turning her head away from me, I'm going to stop here on the way.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. I'll pay for this.
I just loved Angel, and that's basically, I'm just hurting that but thank you for handing me this microphone.
Now I can't tell my story about the time when you said, "I wish I would have said something." You did say something. Thank you very much. Where was that hand up here? There we go.
Oh, God.
You don't have to stand up. It's okay.
Oh,
don't fall down.
I'm used to doing this, you know.
When Dave Yoder was our choir director, after he left, I took over the choir here at Heritage and Pastor Ed. And I remember Marcia and Angel, you know, being here at the time, and Betty as well. And they finally got Angel and Marcia up to the choir. And they were quite an addition to it, believe me. They could really praise the Lord and lead the worship service with me. Yeah, it was really great. But like May said, she was always happy. And we would go to these women's lunches, and Angel would come. The last one I went to that she was there was on the north end of town at that mobile home park, I believe. And she came in and she sat with me and we talked up a storm. Because we were catching up, you know, hadn't seen her in ages and ages. And anyway, I am gonna miss her because every time I saw her, she would always give me a big hug. What a sweet lady. And I can't say enough good things about her. Ken, she was a precious girl. Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Yes. Hope you're not just stretching your fingers.
No. I hope I can get through this. So I met Angel and Ken on the introduction of a plumbing emergency at their house. And I guess that was about 3 or 4 years ago. And right off the bat, I just felt something about her. She was a sweet lady. She knew I was having issues with my family. And she never, not once, failed to invite me to Thanksgiving and Christmas because she knew I was not with my family for one reason or another. And I have fond memories of sitting around and having Thanksgiving and meeting new friends, Archie and his wife, and having Kentucky Fried Chicken. And she was a real blessing. But my most recent experience was a couple of weeks before I got the call from Ken. I was in the house with her, and we were sitting at the table. We were talking. And she told me, she said, "John, I am just so tired, and I am so ready to go home and be with the Lord." And she told me that, and it wasn't even 2 weeks later, Ken called me and told me Angel was in the hospital. And though I prayed and prayed that God would leave her with us, but I knew she was ready to go, and she told me so herself, and God's will be done, and she's with him. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So I hope Ken can draw on this strength and God's word and his promise that she is in so much a better place. No more pain, no more suffering, no more tears. And we just all need to rejoice as her friends. And for Ken and his family, I hope they can lean on those of God's words that assure us that she is so much better off. And I just thank God for the privilege of knowing them. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Anybody else? Yes. I don't want to miss anybody.
What I can say about Angel, what a beautiful name, right? For a beautiful lady, and not only on the outside, absolutely on the inside. Praise our Lord for sending people like Angel.
Very good. Yes, one more thing.
You know, Angel was, she was tired, but, you know, I feel sorry for us because she went home where she was, I know the gates were open for her to come in. You know, she just touched so many people, and she just believed so much that she's taken care of now. It's the rest of us down here that we're waiting to go.
Now you're stealing from my sermon. Yes.
One more thing.
Okay.
Ken, I know Angel is beside Diana at the Rainbow Bridge, helping the Lord welcome all the animals that are coming to him. She loved animals so much. And I am sorry for your loss.
Thank you. Okay. Oh, here we go.
Okay, I met Angel from my mom, Diana. Angel was a very sweet, sweet person. I invited her over to one of our many parties that we had for dinner. And so I just remember her coming over and just like, I was going through such a hard time at that time, but she was one of the first people I met in Pahrump. She welcomed me with open arms, and she was so generous. Everybody's going to miss her. But I know that she's better with him. And Ken, we're there for you if you ever need to talk, you know. So I'm so sorry for your loss, but she's okay.
I love you more. Thank you. Oh, here we go. There you are.
My name is Lilo Kalani Craig. Angel, grandmother, and my grandfather, they were sister and brothers. So me and her were second cousins. But I told her, I'm going to call you auntie because you're older than me. And she said, I like that. So since then, I start calling her auntie. I say, I'll call your husband too, my uncle. So I start calling auntie and uncle. Can I miss her? I love you, Kenna.
Thank you. Yeah. And thank you for the beautiful laser.
Well, I hope I can do this. Anyway, I would never have met Angel if it hadn't been that I've known Ken for almost forever. And of course, they got married, and you couldn't ask for a better woman. And I think we all miss her. But there's something special about her that nobody else seems to have. And this gentleman touched on it. Animals flock to her. You can't believe it. Any animal that's around, they migrate to her. And she nurtures them, and she understands them. It's amazing. It's wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. I don't want to miss anybody. We have time. This is your time. If you don't speak up now, you may regret it. Going once? Going twice? Oh, come on. Who has something to say? Oh, is that a raise? Did you raise your hand? Did I see you raise your hand? No. Okay. All right. Going three times. Sold. Life is full of choices, isn't it? There's so many choices to. We make over 100 decisions each and every day. Did you know that? Yeah, we have to make a decision of, you know, what time to get up. We have to make a decision on what clothes to wear for the day or for work, or and then another set when we get home, huh? And we have to decide which way to go to work, or even if we're going to go to work. We have to take care of other things too, all day long. Choices, choices are always before us. We can never face a day without choices, huh? And well, today, we have a choice to make. The choice is where are we going to spend eternity, huh? You know, some of us have already made that choice. Others just may not want to think about it, you know, but one day that choice is going to be final. And as we gather here today to honor Angel, we're going to be faced with the most important question. Where are we going to spend eternity when we leave this earth, huh? You know, it's times like this when we experience our mortality, huh? None of us are going to live forever. We know that, especially us old folks. As Christians, we realize that we're only on this earth temporarily, and that our ultimate goal is to spend eternity with our Lord in heaven. Now, you know, some people, you know, they're only given days on this planet here, like the young children who pass without ever having a chance to experience life. While others, like Angel, and old folks like me, are given many good years to find a mate, to watch their children grow and their grandchildren as well, huh? But there are no guarantees. We don't have a guarantee that we may be here another second. Each one of us could leave this room today and be gone tomorrow, or even today. As we leave this church and get involved in an automobile accident, you know, we have some pretty crazy drivers here in Pahrump. You gotta watch them. I can't help think about a service I did a while back, though. for an 18-year-old girl who is mixing drugs and alcohol. One evening after a visit with her father, she came home and she asked her mom, "Mom, can I lay down in your bed?" Mom says, "Sure." She went to sleep and she never woke up. You know, when God says it's your time, it's your time. Yeah, there's times, these are the times that remind us to get our lives in order, isn't it? That's why we have these things, these times. Jesus died on the cross for our sins. What a great deal that was. All he asks is that we accept him as our Lord and Savior, confess our sins, and repent. Can it be any easier than that? Yeah, repentance. That's key. And that means a sincere commitment not to sin again. Oh, sure, you know, we may slip up. I do, yeah. And God knows, he knows that we'll slip up because he created us. He knows that we're able to slip up. After all, he was the creator of each and every one of us. But he also knows that we got to keep on trying. Keep running that race to the finish line to join him and our loved ones in heaven. And we can't give up trying, no matter what happens. We got to also recognize that our time here on earth is but a short stay compared to eternity. Our ultimate goal. We got to keep up the good fight, as the Apostle Paul said, and run that race and catch that gold ring. In the book of Matthew, one of the apostles asked, "Teacher, what is the great commandment in the law?" And Jesus said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. This is the first and the great commandment, and the second is just like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Amen? Amen. Easy to do, isn't it? Love God with your whole heart, your mind, your soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. If we can do that, we got our hand on that gold ring, don't we? And we're going home, and we're going to see Angel, and I'll bet you, when it's our time to pass, Angel's going to be there with her arms wide open, looking at us and say, "Hey, what took you so long?" And I'm going to say, "He had me in jail." Yeah. I want to thank you all for coming here to honor that beautiful lady today. Please bow your heads. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the time that you gave us with your servant Angel. Surely, by her actions, she loved you. She loved her family and her neighbors. Please, Lord, take care of her whilst we wait to join her in your loving arms. In Jesus' name I pray, and everybody says, amen. Amen. Now, may the Lord bless each and every one of you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Now go in peace. Love and serve the Lord. And one last thing. Now I'm going to sound like one of those long-winded preachers like Pastor Ron. Dealing with grief, for some, it can be difficult. Talk to each other. If you start feeling sad, feeling that grief mourning, talk to each other. Call each other. Keep in contact with each other. And if you find that grief becomes overwhelming, give me a call. If you don't know my number, just call the sheriff's office. They know where I'm at 24 hours a day. They do ask that you don't dial 911, though, as some of my friends have done. But I'll refer you to Marcia. If you don't have her number, you can get it here today. Marcia Savage heads a local grief support group over at the Central Valley Church here in Pahrump for those who've lost loved ones. And she's helped many people work through their grief. And she can help you, too. So keep that in mind. If you think you need her number, stop it and get her number today. If she's busy talking to other people, come see me. I've got her number. I'll give it to you. So now it's time to adjourn. It's time to add to our celebration, have some munchies. And we've got a lot of munchies in the back, thanks to the family. Thank you very much for providing those. So feel free to just walk out, enjoy yourself, party on, and celebrate this time and say, thank you, Lord, for the time you gave us with Angel. I also, as a little bit of advertising here for Heritage Bible Church, tomorrow is their chili cook-off from 11 till 2, if I've got that time right. One. Oh, Saturday. Okay, Saturday. Be here for the chili cook-off. And they make great chili here. I'm going to be here. I like chili. So thank you. Please, stand up and go to the back. Go to the kitchen.